हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू आईटीएलएस एकेडमी। आवर लेक्चर इज स्टूल कल्चर एंड दिस टाइम वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी स्टूल कल्चर फॉर ई कोलाई 0157H7। एम ऑफ द टेस्ट। First point is, the aim is to detect E. coli 0157H7 from stool specimen or rectal swab and perform sensitivity test. The latex test will demonstrate by slight agglutination. E. coli strains possessing the somatic 0157 antigen and flagellar H7 antigen. A stool culture perhaps helps the doctor see if there is a bacterial infection in the intestine. Next point is, a stool or feces sample can provide doctors with valuable informations about what's going on when a child has a problem in the stomach or intestine or other parts of the gastrointestinal tract or gastrointestinal system. Next point is, a technician places small stool samples in sterile plastic dishes with nutrients that encourage the growth of certain bacteria. The targeted bacteria will only grow if they are already in the stool sample. If bacterial colonies form, the technician evaluates them using a microscope and a chemical test to identify the organism. Next point is, a doctor may request a stool culture to look for illness causing bacteria such as Shigella, Salmonella, Yersinia, Campylobacter, E. coli, and sometimes other bacteria are found. Also, the stool culture might be ordered if you or your child has diarrhea for several days or has bloody diarrhea, especially if there has been an outbreak of foodborne illness in your community. Your child or you has recently eaten undercooked meat or eggs or unpasteurized milk or recently traveled to certain places outside the country. E. coli. First point is, E. coli or Escherichia coli is a type of bacteria that normally lives in your intestine. It is also found in the gut of some animals. Most types of E. coli are harmless and even help keep your digestive tract healthy. But some strains can cause diarrhea if you eat contaminated food or drink foul water. Next point is, while many of us associate E. coli with food poisoning, you can also get pneumonia and urinary tract infections from different types of the bacteria. In fact, 75% to 95% of urinary tract infections are caused by E. coli. Some versions of E. coli make you sick by making a toxin called Shiga. This toxin damages the lining of your intestine. The strains of E. coli that make the toxin are sometimes called STEC, which is short for Shiga toxin producing E. coli. Shiga is like this is Shiga and this is a form of toxin produced by E. coli. Next point is, one especially bad strain, that is 0157H7, can make you very sick. It causes abdominal cramps, vomiting and bloody diarrhea. It is the leading cause of acute kidney failure in children. It can also cause life-threatening symptoms. Here you can see E. coli internal infections specimen is stool. You can see these are cultures of E. coli. These dots are representing colonies of E. coli. This is plain plate having media. In this particular plate, you can see there is a huge growth of E. coli, and this is clamp of E. coli. This is colony of E. coli. Here, culture media is McConkie agar media. pH indicator is neutral red. Red in acid medium and colorless in basic medium. Red colonies indicates lactose positive. These red color colonies shown over here representing lactose positive E. coli colonies. As we know that lactose is the source of nutrition for most of the time in E. coli. These colonies are round, shiny and 2 to 3 nanometers. Types of specimen in case of E. coli: stool or rectal swab or stool, fresh random in fecal transport system. Criteria of specimen rejection include formed stool, specimen contaminated with urine, residual soap or disinfectants. Specimens received in grossly leaking transport containers, diapers, dry specimens. Specimens submitted in fixative or additives. If any of these conditions is present, then there are higher chances of rejection of your specimen. Here comes pre-specimen processing. First of all, patient preparing. Point first is instruct the patient on how the specimen should be collected and transferred. Next point will be to the container provided him or her with stick and containers. Specimen collection. See specimen collection under stool culture and routine. Quantity of specimen. The specimen should contain at least 5 gram of feces. Time relapse before processing the sample. Stool samples should be examined and cultured as soon as possible after collection. Storage done in refrigerated conditions, that is at 2 to 8 degrees centigrade. Unacceptable condition is multiple specimens more than 1 in 24 hours or delayed transport without use of appropriate transport media. Stability is in transport media ambient 1 hour, refrigerated 72 hour and frozen unacceptable. We can say that for the stability of a specimen, there must not be frozen condition. Frozen is unacceptable condition. Here you can see a brief overview of identification of pathogenic E. coli is given. You can see it is ECL approach for identification of pathogenic E. coli. First of all, sample is taken. Sample enrichment is done overnight. After enrichment of sample, there is a process of multiplex PCR. This multiplex PCR helps in gaining the amount of particular specimen. After PCR, here rapid evaluation of the virulence potential of the sample, and it is also known as pathotype. After this whole process, sample analysis is done. If there is not sample but there is E. coli isolate is present, then the process will be, we will take E. coli isolate, then we will transfer it on agar plate. After transfer with agar plate, we will do virotyping or multiplex PCR or colony hybridization. Next process we will do is serotyping, and the third process we will do is pulse typing or PFGE. When these processes are complete, then there will be identification and virotyping of the isolate, and at last this isolate will be analyzed. This is the whole process of identification of pathogenic E. coli. In case if you have sample and enrichment of the sample is done, then you can directly transfer it to the agar plate, and by the process of this particular type you can directly isolate analysis you can do. You can see these are the colonies of E. coli. These are clumps, these are colonies of E. coli, and as we know that E. coli is rod shaped bacteria, so all the colonies, all the shape of bacteria is given is rod shaped. Procedure. First of all, we will see principle of the test procedure. The principle is latex particles are coated with an anti serum against E. coli 0157 antigen. When the coated latex particles are mixed with fresh colonies of E. coli serotype 0157, the bacteria will bind to the anti-serum, causing the latex particles to visibly agglutinate, that is positive reaction. Bacteria which are not 0157 serotype will not bind to the anti-serum and will not result in agglutination or negative reaction. Next comes test procedure. Allow all reagents to come to room temperature before use. The E. coli 0157 latex reagent and negative control latex reagent must be tested with the positive control antigen prior to running test specimens. The E. coli 0157 latex reagent must show positive agglutination, and the negative control latex reagent must show no agglutination within 2 minutes. This whole process indicates that the reagents retain their activity. In any particular case, the doctor or hospital laboratory will usually provide written instructions on how to collect a stool sample. If instructions are not provided, here are tips for collecting a stool sample. Some tips are: be sure to wear protective gloves and wash your hands and your child's hands afterwards. Specimen processing. The media is sorbitol McConkey agar media, or in short SMAC. The culturing procedure is: first point, a loop full of stool is streaked on sorbitol McConkey. Incubate at 37 degrees centigrade. NSF colonies may be taken from SMAC or sorbitol McConkey agar plates, or alternatively NSF isolates. Next point is, under aerobic conditions, examine plates for non-sorbitol fermenting colonies, that is NSF. It is necessary to test up to 10 separate NSF colonies to ensure a high probability of detection from mixed cultures. Here may be inoculated onto non-selective agar media for testing. These NSF can be inoculated onto non-selective agar media. Here the process of detection is given. You can see, first of all, there you will take a stool specimen. After that, there will be process of inoculation. After inoculation, sorbitol or McConkey agar will be used and colonies will be cultured out. Next process will include incubation for 24 hours at 37 degrees centigrade. After incubation, pick up non-sorbitol fermenting colonies, that is NSF colonies, and finally perform latex agglutination using 0157 and H7 anti-serum. Next comes latex procedure. First point is, bring the latex resins to room temperature. Make sure the latex suspensions are mixed by vigorous shaking. Expel any latex from the dropper pipette for complete mixing. Point 2 is, dispense one drop of the test latex onto a circle of the black slide. Now place it close to the edge of the circle. Point 3 is add some loop full of some loop fulls or a pasture piped drop of saline to the circle. Ensure that the latex and saline do not mix at this stage. Point 4 is using a loop, pick off a portion of the colony to be tested and carefully emulsify in the saline drop. Point 5 is mix the test latex and suspension together and spread to cover most of the reaction area using the loop, and now flame the loop. Point 6 is rock the slide in a circular motion, observing for agglutination. Do not rock the card for more than 1 minute and do not use a magnifying glass. Point 7 is, if no agglutination occurs, then proceed to test other NSF colonies if these are present. Point 8 is, if agglutination with your test reason does occur, then it is necessary to test a further portion of the colony with the controlled reason to ensure that the isolate is not an autoagglutinin strain. When finished, dispose of the reaction slide into disinfectant. Interpretation. We are going to see interpretations regarding positive, negative, and non-interpretable results. Positive result. Agglutination of the test latex occurs within 1 minute. No agglutination of the control latex. Perform biochemical test to confirm that the organism is an E. coli strain. When these are negative results, then no agglutination of the test latex. Next is non-interpretable result. Clumping of the control latex. Post-specimen processing. Interfering factor patient on antibiotic therapy and improper sample collection. Result reporting. A positive report will be issued only in case E. coli 0570157H7 were isolated. Otherwise, a negative report will be issued. Turnaround time. Negative results are sent out 72 hours after receipt of the specimen. Results of positive cultures can be expected in 4 to 5 days. Thank you guys for watching this session. You can follow ITLS Academy on Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, YouTube, WhatsApp and LinkedIn. For latest videos and updates, you can subscribe ITLS Academy on YouTube. You can also get it on Google Play Store. So thank you very much for watching this session. Guys, you can like, share and subscribe ITLS Academy. For any help or query, you can call us on 7080833450. You can also reach us on www.itlsacademy.com. Thank you very much again for watching this session.